Hello there. In this video, we'll be showing you how to paint your Beasts of Chaos Great Bray-Shaman. We'll be painting quickly and efficiently to get your models looking great on the battlefield in no time at all. The first thing we've done is undercoat our model, and for this colour scheme, we've used Grey Sear. The paints you'll need are on the screen now. The great thing about this guide is that it uses just 10 paints. Remember that these are our recommendations. Feel free to paint your miniatures however you like. If you are new to painting or want to know the paints and techniques used in this video, check out our Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos in the description. For our first paint, we'll be using GORE-GRUNTA fur, and we're going to use it to paint the staff and the inside of the cloak. When painting difficult areas to reach like the inside of the cloak, make sure to use a small layer brush. We're doing the cloak first, as it's the most difficult part of the model to paint, and it also means that if we get it painted now, we won't have to worry about painting it later when we've got more details on the model. Don't worry if you make any splodges anywhere, because we are going to paint over the rest of the details later. And there we go, with the staff and the inside of the cloak painted, arguably our most difficult part of the model is done. For our next paint, we're going to use Black Templar, and we're going to use this to paint the leather sections, the hooves, as well as inside the mouth. Black Templar is a lighter black than Black Legion or Abaddon Black, and has a slight blue tone finish. This will help to put some more colours in the model later on, as well as pull away from the edges because it's a contrast paint. This allows us to get some nice free highlights. Again, it's worth picking out the most difficult areas to paint first. When painting the larger leather sections on the cloak, make sure to have plenty of paint on the brush. This will help when applying it over these sections because the paint will pull away from the raised areas and then collect in the recesses. This will give us some natural shading. The coloured areas on the patchwork cloak are meant to be quite random, so you can pick out any areas you want to, or you can just follow the way we're doing it here. For our third paint, we'll be using Karak stone. We'll be using it to pick out leather details, ropes, and ribbons. It is a lighter brown and has a pale tone compared to the other paints, which will help to add some contrast to our colours. Karak stone is a layer paint, so once you've applied your first layer, just make sure to do a second layer for good coverage. Karak stone looks great as the stitchings on our patchwork leather cloak. It really adds some contrast to it. When painting the stitching, just take your time doing it as it's a small detail. The good thing about using Karak stone is that it's a very light paint, so if you do get any mess anywhere, you can easily tidy up using the previous contrast colours that we did. For our next paint, we'll be using GORTHOR brown. We'll use it to pick out all the skin and fur details. GORTHOR brown is a layer paint, but perfect for the fur colour we want. A good tip here is to use a medium or small layer brush in order to gain better control when painting around the previous details. When going around our previously painted areas, just take your time not to get any of the paint on the previous details. When you're finished with your first coat, as always, just let it dry and come back and do a second one for good coverage. And there we go. With that paint applied, our model is starting to come to life. We are now halfway through our paints. And for our fifth paint, we'll be using Blood Angel's Red. We'll be picking out the cloth, tongue, as well as the eyes. Once you have allowed the first coat to dry, just come back with Blood Angel's Red and apply it into the recesses of the cloth. This will help to put in some shading. For the eyes and tongue, we're using a small layer brush in order to have better control. A good tip here, as always, when doing these small details, is just to hold your breath, as this will help to steady your hand. Blood Angel's Red is a fantastic contrast red that is full of colour. For our next step, we need to pick out the metallics, and for this we'll be using Lead Belcher. The only area that we need metallics for is at the tip of the staff, just underneath the skull. Once you've finished with Lead Belcher, just remember to change your water, as you don't want to get any metallic flakes into the rest of your paints. It's now time to pick out all the bone details on our model, and for this we'll be using Skeleton Horde. We will need two layers of this. After the first coat has dried, apply a second straight into the recesses and anywhere you think there would be no light to add depth to your bone. With the bone details complete, all our main colours are on the model. It's now time for some shading. Now we are going to be using AGRAX EARTHSHADE, and we're going to apply this over the fur details as well as the bone in select areas. If you see the paint pooling anywhere, remember, all you need to do is dry off your brush and soak up the excess with the dry bristles. When applying the AGRAX EARTHSHADE over the bone, a good tip here is just to pick out the deepest recesses. When shading the horns, apply more at the bottom and less at the top because this will create a gradient. With the AGRAX EARTHSHADE applied, we can see how the bone details have really started to look nicely aged. Our next shade will be NULN Oil. We are going to be applying this on the metallic areas, select deepest recesses, the rock, and the hair, so our shaman looks ancient and battle-worn. The reason we're applying it into the deepest recesses of the model is that it just helps to make some of the details pop. Try not to overload your brush, but if you do, dry off and soak up the excess. Depending on where you're using NULN Oil, remember, you can use a small or medium layer brush to help you control the amount of shade that you're applying into those recesses. When painting the rock that the shaman has stood on, use a larger brush for this. When the first coat is dry, apply a second coat. And there we go. All that's left is our final stage, which we'll be highlighting. For our final paint, we'll be using Screaming Skull, and we're going to be dry brushing this all over the model. We are going to be using a small dry brush for this and applying it all over the model. Remember, don't go overboard here. It's far easier to add more dry brush highlights to the model than it is to correct an over-enthusiastic dry brush. Screaming Skull is a nice neutral colour that helps to tie all the colours on the model together. We have focused the dry brush on the cloak, the bone details, and any of the higher sections of the fur. And there we are. Your Beasts of Chaos, Great Bray-Shaman, is finished and ready for battle in the mortal realms. You can see that our model is based in Armageddon Dunes, but you can base it in any colour you'd like. If you'd like to learn more about basing, check out our technical paints video on how to base your models. Well, we hope you've enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time. Bye-bye!